She's returned, Geralt. After all these years.
The man who meets the hunt returns to this world. I returned.
Alright, what's happening my friends? Welcome back to some more Witcher 3 The Wild Hunt gameplay. We're just outside Keira Metz's place, which in turn is just outside Midcups, but we all know that already. You can see, if you look over to the left side of the screen, the pillar is still lurking about, and I did go into the journal. I was taking a good look at the these two new missions that I've acquired here, at the that I had acquired at the tail end of last episode, both one involving the pillar, the other for Keira Metz, as we have truly turned into her little lackey. With the hopes of some grand night of, something for the ages. Yes, something the Witcher will be talking about for years to come. Pillar, sir, you best get moving. Now, after looking at the journal, he wants me out at Fike Isle by midnight tonight, you know? Or I think it was that it could happen at a later date. But the Witcher is the one that wants to get it done tonight at midnight. So I'm going to try and shoot for that, even though we've now broken 6 o'clock. And I'd like to try and get this other mission going as well. I can't imagine this is going to be too involved. It's drawn me back towards Hangman's Alley. And this is, of course, for Keira Metz. If we go back in here and have a quick look at it, favor for a friend. When the devil cannot go himself, he sends a woman. And when a sorceress is indisposed, she sends a witcher to do her errands. That at least was Keira Metz's approach, finding herself in a bit of a pinch. She asked Geralt for yet another favor. This time she needed him to track down a merchant's wagon, which had been carrying some rare magic ingredients her way. It had never arrived, and she had begun to fear the worst. And I guess we'll go and take a look at this, although, you know, I'm a little strained here for both time and distance. I may be best to hit up the pillar initially. And head for Fike Isle, you know, because we've got a bit of a journey here. And it's right here, because on the rundown on his mission, in particular, has me directed for that kind of ritualistic area. During his travels through No Man's Land, Geralt ran into the pillar once more. The strange fellow had had a favor to ask of the Witcher. He wanted Geralt to help him perform a cherished local peasant rite, known as Forefather's Eve. During this ritual, he explained, lost spirits are summoned and their deeds judged. Fantastic material, by the way, for a poet looking to make his name with an atmospheric ballad. This Forefather's Eve was set to be held at midnight on Fike Isle, and Geralt, having no other plans and his curiosity piqued, promised to attend. And actually, the rundown, how I knew I was being directed to a little stony area. Meet the Peller in the Stone Circle on Fike Isle at midnight. That was the pop-up I had seen. Alright, anyway, maybe I should head there. You know, I'm getting a little short on time, especially with this extensive rundown that I'm, of course, well known for at the start of many of these episodes. Now, let's take a look. I can't imagine this is going to be too much. It could just be a matter of tracking down the where the wagon was last seen. Get running a quick investigation. Pillar, I will expect you this eve, sir. Fike Isle, yes. Be there. And there was one more thing I wanted to touch upon. One more location. I can't remember what it's called now. I think it was called Wastrel Manor. And it was where we saw a couple of tents pitched. That's where we initially got the pop-up for it last episode. After I had lowered the bridge and was on my way towards Keira, I believe, is where I stumbled across it. And there were a few tents there. Anyway, if we look at the map, I think I just ran into something. I was looking down at the keyboard, though. If we look at the map here, this was interesting, with Wastrel Manor. If we look at the rundown for it, the once beautiful manor house located near here was known for its extravagant balls, which were attended by the cream of the local youth. Its owners abandoned it over a century ago, but soon afterwards it became a place of worship for the local community, which believes a deity dwells in the ruins, and I have to believe that despite Wastrel Manor being marked out here, this is probably the ruin. And we could have some sort of a nasty foe in there, that of course some locals have built a cult around and are praying to. So maybe if I go search it, we'll find some decent loot. You know, that was of course running through my mind. We could have a good battle on our hands here. We've got bandits on horseback, really. You know, if I had to guess, I would say these scallywags. Oh my god, I cut him in half. That's one way to get him off his horse. Oh, and a second one falls to my greatness. I'm coming off, you know. Here we go. Here we go. Oh, nice. That's what I was hoping would happen. Oh, fantastic. I am loving it. Now, there was one more roaming around here somewhere. Here's the thing that I was thinking there. If these bandits on horseback could very well be involved in this missing merchant's cart. So, they were chasing me out of the area several episodes ago when I was much weaker, man. Geralt came back to settle an old score with these fellows. Yes, he did. All right. Again, I've no time to waste. We're approaching 7 o'clock. Oh my! I'm heading in the completely the opposite direction of Fike Isle. It's not good. Ride, Roche, and ride hard, my friend. And I use that term friend loosely. Oh yeah, that's right. We're heading back for Hangman's Alley. All right. All right, we've got drowners down there. We've got track carts. Or track carts. We've got track carts here, people. We've got cart tracks. That's what I'm trying to say.
Wide, heavy wheels. Merchant's wagon.
Oh my, really? Waterhead coming out of here? Get out of here with that. You old shit water special. I won't stand for it, you hag. Get out of here. And again, you not listen. Oh, that hurt. Get the damn shield up, witcher, please. I'm about done with you, hag. Oh, loosen the head of the creature. Oh, damn, I thought she was sitting there propped up. Just waiting for the head to come off. Look at her! Look at her, she's just lounging here now. Lounging in death. Yes. Having a grand old time here. Enjoying the sunset, clearly. Clearly. Now what else, I'm being held in battle here by a couple of foul drowners, really. Oh, nice. I nearly took his head off as he was just falling lifelessly to his knees. Alright, I think that's the last of the baddies in the area, currently. At least I can get a proper investigation going now. And, Geralt was on about, you know, I think he was saying something about the drowners, mumbling something to himself. Maybe I should investigate this again. I can't actually do that, unfortunately. We'll continue to, scour the area for signs of this cart. For anything out of the ordinary. Here we go. Something right up here. A little sulfur. Alchemy paste. These could be some of the ingredients she's looking for. What am I walking into over here? I've completely left the search area now. We've got something away down there. It's probably just an ingredient. Hmm. Do you think the ingredients are perhaps scattered about here? I think first thing I need to do is actually track down where this cart has ended up. So I guess following the bloody tracks would be the right choice, wouldn't it? Yes, it would. Did it get derailed here, perhaps? No. I'm still moving forward with it. All right. That's the end of it. That is the end of it. Perhaps a dragon in here. I could have sworn I just came up here, though. There's something off in the distance there. Again, it's probably just... Yeah, I mean, it's just going to be an ingredient of some kind. White myrtle petals in this instance. There's a little chest. It looks like a little chest anyway. No, it's a little log or something. Should I perhaps move beyond the trail here? I guess let's go and search this up. See what exactly this is. Oh, here we go. Oh no, it's blood moss. Not really what I'm looking for, is it? No, it's not. Well, I have to admit I'm a little baffled here. I think if I had actually heard what Geralt was mumbling to himself, I'd have a better idea of what I was to deal with, but that fell water hag arrived on the scene. Titties flapping all over the place. And had to be put down, clearly. Look at the posse out here. What are we looking at here? Wolves, wild dogs, something. Clearly. Alright, let me put the damn blade away. And there must be something I'm missing here along the path. Nothing I can examine, unfortunately. I mean, it's glowing red quite clearly. Maybe the cart was headed in the other direction. Or then again, maybe it was just dragged over here. No, this is where I was doing battle. So that's nothing. Damn it, I'm pressed for time. I've no time for this lollygagging. Yes. Roche here. Here we go. Alright. There's a wagon wheel. Oh my. You know what? I liked how the search area didn't actually change until I clued in and left the area. You know, that's what was really holding me back there.
You're off the road at high speed. Doesn't bode well.
Clearly, no. Perhaps it was being pursued by those mounted bandits, Witcher. What say you, sir? Do you agree? He's like, hurts he quiet down.
Yeah, merchant traveling across Velen alone. No way that was gonna end well.
He's like, hurts he quiet down, let me do what I do. You just continue to... sit there and look pretty, yes, I don't know. I was going to say, you just continue to run your mouth and entertain the good people of the internet, but he was basically telling me to pipe down at the same time. All right, let's get all this together.
Leftovers, cuts of meat, cataplepis. Wonder what spell requires that. A dry red from Zubaran, southern slope. Notes of black currant and citrus. Pains the heart.
We've got something foul sitting over there in the bush, hiding along the tree line.
Hacker's still intact. Don't sense anything magic, though. Wonder how Kira will explain this one.
It's probably some goddamn dress or something.
Woman from an artery. Can't be far. Wouldn't have made it.
Geralt could be a little sexy lingerie. Oh my. Oh, we got a little rot fiend action. He's gonna have to be dealt with, clearly. Damn it. Oh no. Foul creature, die already. That's Geralt, you just stick to the sword work, sir. You let me do the ribbings, yes. You let me handle the trash talk, thank you. Alright, there's still a bit more over here. Anything worth examining?
I waited for help. It never came.
Oh, die.
It's Velen for you.
Missing merchant's letter. Here we go. Perhaps a final will and testament. You know, maybe just a quick little explanation of what actually transpired here on this eve. Is it quest item? No, it's not. Let's check it. Here we go. Let's have a quick read. Volker. Haven't we heard the name Volker mentioned before? I think there was another. I'm almost certain of it. This Volker fella. He's a real mover and shaker around these parts. You know, he's got lots of businesses, little underhanded dealings taking place. I think. I could be mistaken. Anyway, we've hit gold, old friend. Not only have we sold all of our stock, we have sold it for 3 times its cost. Our customer wants it all. Wine from Beauclair, everything from yes, to the oldest vintages, white, red, and rose. You name it. Some meats, some pickled beef, some pepper, cinnamon, cloves, I'm telling you, old friend, everything. There's one catch, however. We must deliver the goods to Velen, to a village called Midcops. I know, dangerous, what with the war and all. But think of the coin, my friend. I've managed to secure a pass that will get you across the Pontar. And then it's just a hop, skip, and a jump, and you're there. You'll be fine. From Klaus. We'll split the proceeds fitty-fitty. So, Well, we've seen wines mentioned here. You know, I don't know. I don't know what's actually in this box. The wine was busted up over by the cart. I have a feeling it's some, you know... Well, I can hope. Hope that it's some sexy lingerie for Keira Metz. For the lovely Keira. And we will perhaps christen this sexy lingerie, yes. Yes, we will. Anyway, okay, at this point, I don't want to ride for Kira's joint just yet. I don't have time to even stop in there, and who knows what we get dragged into. If my theory is correct, well, we could be there all night. What I need to do is change gears here, change direction, and get to Fike Isle. I've got 3 hours to get out into the middle of that damn lake. And it's going to be a mad dash, methinks. I could ride hard for Orton. You know what I could do? I think I'll just stop right here and grab that boat. Hey-ya. Come on, Roche. Let out, my friend. Again, I use the term loosely. Yes. Yes, I do. All right, I have to believe that with what's it been? About 3 quests with involving Keira. That this could be the last of it, you know. This could be the last of it. It's simply devolved into minor fetch quests now at this point. You know, the whole Fike Isle curse removal was pretty good. The Elven Ruins was awesome, where we ran into Nethra. But the last one there, my god, it was a lowly rod fiend and a foul shit-serving water hag, yes, with the floppy titties. And and we're picking up a dress or something for Keira. Good lord, bitcher. Get in that damn boat, sir. Get in there now. Come on now. Don't be stubborn. Alright. You're on the wrong end of it, sir. Oh, is it tethered? Oh, no. I saw the rope. I thought it was tied to something on the shore. Anyway, here we go. How we looking? You know, I've timed this out quite nicely, I have to admit. You know, by the time we get there, it'll probably be about 10 o'clock. Give us a couple of hours to maybe sit and relax, you know. Among the cursed lands of Fike Isle, with rot fiends circling all about. I tell you, this boat, I for some reason I remember the boats being a little swifter. I'm not really sure what the deal is with this one. Maybe it's got a hole in it. Well, it's got several holes up there in the mast. Probably affecting performance here. I don't know. Okay, so how are we looking for time? We're looking fantastic for time right now. So we'll do this Forefather's Eve. I can't imagine there's going to be too much to it, but we may be here for the night. We'll head back, meet up with Keira, and I may try and get into Orton here. There, as I recall, you know, since we're not far from Orton when we're at Fike Isle, I could stop in town and inquire about this, see if I can't find myself this boat builder. Yes. That the Baron had mentioned, and find myself a game of cards, or have myself a game of cards. A game of Gwent. Of course, we've got again, I can't remember what it's called. Wastrel Manor, or something like that. Alright, now don't beach the sucker. Oh, what are you doing, Geralt? Drinking a tawny owl needlessly. Here we go. What is this now? Ugh. We got an angry mob coming in here. That's what they listed as, the mob. Oh my, Geralt. What's happening? Must I inquire? No, they're all tight-lipped. Perhaps they know you're up to no good out here, Vetcher. They're here to protest at the Peller or something, I don't know. Or maybe they're here to take part in the ritual, I really can't say. They are an unruly mob, though. As I hear it told. Look at this. I'm getting chills here, people. I'm getting chills. Shall we walk amongst the peasants and the people? This is pretty cool. Don't let them know you've looted their you know, their old ruins here, Vetcher. They clearly won't be pleased. I'll tell you what, this is pretty cool. I wasn't expecting all these people. I thought it was just going to be me, the Peller, and that plowing goat of his. Yes, princess. Oh, princess. Alright. Geralt truly is a man of the people, as you can see. Yes. He enters the ritual area. The arena, the stadium. He enters the ring via the crowd. The people's champion, they call him, yes. Witcher Geralt hurts. There's the Peller right there. Let's have words here.
Greetings.
Just in time. Good folk, behold the one who will protect us. You needn't fear.
I don't know. You have a lot of faith in me here, Peller.
Summon the wandering souls. Beyond all help, some will be. From these, you must protect us. Evil creatures, keep at bay. Keep at bay till the ritual's done.
Well, do I need to meditate? I'm thinking. You know, I'm down one tawny hour, but I think my swallows and everything are okay. Let's do it. I should have probably gotten
Begin.
A quick save in.
Keep us from harm, and let them not disturb the circle.
Suppose I'll have to do it now. I have to figure
what
it's gonna be.
Life?
I'm just gonna take a guess. You know, since he's summoning, you know, spirits. That it's going to be specters, wraiths, etc. And we'll get a little specter oil on there. Do I want the tawny owl out? Why not? You know what I could do? I'm getting 80 toxicity out of this, though. I don't know if I like it. I'm going to have to start using them, though, you know. Besides, I want to see if it will actually refill. Much the same way my other potions will. I have to guess it probably will. Alright, so, what would be the best bet here? Whenever single hit drains Mutnaw, and I don't think that's gonna work. Geralt's maximum vitality is increased with each foe killed. This increase lasts until he meditates. What's happening? Is that the music? Is there a battle playing it right now? I will take this Night Wraith decoction. Let's do it. So my vitality is gonna go up with each foe I fell. And it's gonna last until I meditate or fast travel. Alright, perfect. Tawny Owl's in there. I think we'll get rid of this. Well, Bring in the Devil's Puffball. Yes. Yes, fantastic, Vetcher. Alright.
Well, you know.
Can't quick save right now, unfortunately. Oh,
what
my.
Comes next once life subsides?
Mine is all fate decides.
Soon will rise thy dead, thy buried.
Each will say by what they're hurried.
Will ye grant these souls reprieve?
The storm, damn it.
Let's begin Forefather's Eve. Ye who wander on the gale, ever caught in this world's thrall, see this sign, gentle pale. Ye we summon, ye we call.
Oh my. Oh no, I really wasn't expecting all this. I was expecting spirits. Damn drowners here.
Ye we summon, ye we call. Enter souls, we'll judge ye all.
Oh, wow.
I may not be surviving this. Where was my last quick save? A lot of drowners in here, Geralt. A lot of drowners,
something
sir.
Something whispers, something thinks. Someone here are fire freaks.
Oh no, have I exceeded my maximum toxicity? I gotta be really careful. I'm gonna have to really watch that. You know what? It looks like I have. Oh wow. Damn it. I'm gonna have to. I may have to drink this. I think that's what this is. The white honey, it's gonna clear all toxicity, but it's gonna cancel all my active potion effects, which is a real shame. But I may have to go to it. We'll see here.
Gale, ever caught in this world's thrall, see this sign, gentle tale. Ye we summon, ye we call.
No. Oh no, oh no, oh no. Damn it.
Burn the incense ever higher.
As if I got a face full of the shit water special. Just as I was trying to get the shield up.
Enter souls, we'll judge ye all.
There you go, Butcher. You definitely needed that, sir. Oh no! Right at the end? Are you kidding me? Oh damn. You know what? I probably have some sort of an autosave that came in there. Let's load it up.
I return.
What is this life? Well, you know.
Alright, you know what? Here we go. Now that I know what I'm gonna be dealing with, that was bloody awful. I don't know why, I got too concerned with the fact that I didn't have a quick save in, you know, and I started thinking about it. I don't know if it's a wise choice to grab this, to start guzzling these. I'm really going to have to consider increasing my maximum toxicity threshold, you know. I think I'd like to get one in, though. Here's what I'm going to do. We're going to get the Necrophage Oil. This should be played much better this time. At least that's what I'm hoping for. I will get the... I think we'll go... We'll get that in there. I will guzzle the Night Wraith decoction. And I'll get the White Honey in here as backup. Just in case I need to shut things down really quickly. And I'll get some water in there, you know. He's clearly, you know, with all this, with the high toxicity levels, he's got the cotton mouth. And he's probably a little dehydrated, and we'll use the water to maintain some level of health.
What comes next once life subsides?
What a great little mission. Oh my God. You got such a great vibe here.
Will ye grant these souls reprieve?
We're prepared to end their grief.
Let's begin Forefather's Eve.
Here we go.
Ye who wander on the gale, ever caught in this world's thrall, see this sign, gentle tale. Ye we summon, ye we call.
Ye we summon, ye we
call. Hark, a sound I hear. Tis right.
Damn it. The shit water surprise.
Burn the incense ever higher.
Unbelievable. I don't know what happened to the drowner. I think he took a shitwater special to the back of the noodle. And that'll knock you stupid. Clearly. Even the drowners will get knocked a little stupid by it. Here we go, here we go. I'll tell you, we got quite the crowd forming here.
Something thinks. Someone here are fire creeps.
Okay, one thing I... Actually, that's not what I wanted. What I want to do is get a bomb up here.
Ye who wander on the gale, ever hold in this world's
oh, there's see my encounter to the shit water special. Oh no, not
ye
much of one though,
summon,
unfortunately.
Ye we call.
Oh, dang. That really messes with your mojo. There we go. Get rid of her. Get rid of her, Hector. There you go, sir. Off with your head, foul hag. And yours as well, sir. Oh, my. I can't believe I died there. So terrible.
Hark, a sound I hear. 'Tis right. A spirit breaks the still of night.
Burn the incense ever higher. Spirit, join us round the fire.
Spirit, speak. This time is yours. Tell us of your ghostly woes.
Look at Geralt. He's really messed up with the high level toxicity happening right now. Should I drive him away, Peller?
Should I drive him away?
Nay. I've come for you, patricide.
Begone, foul force! I cast upon you the light of the eternal fire!
Oh my. They're finally sticking their nose around here, are they?
Abomination! Stop this at once!
The errant souls! We must help them!
Silence! I'll not tolerate necromancy.
Help me.
Fine. Peller, I will, sir. I respect you. You're a little strange, and I don't care much for your plowing goat princess, but I will help you on this Forefather's Eve.
Leave now. You're disrupting the ritual.
This is black magic. These folk disturb the dead. We cannot allow it. We will not.
You don't know a thing about their customs.
Take him, and disperse the others.
You can try, gentlemen.
Good folk, leave not these grounds. Ye cannot break the circle.
A little black magic for you right there, my friend. Yes, yes I do. Oh my, Peller under attack here. Oh dang. Cut him down, Vitcher. There you go. Drive him through. There should be one left somewhere.
It is an ill turn. Ill. Woe away. Blood has stained the hallowed ground. Yet we cannot stop what has begun.
Continue, sir.
If you want to continue, I'm ready.
Good folk, we must the eve complete. Prepare yourselves.
This is awesome. Just,
ye we
you know.
Ye we call. Enter souls, we'll judge ye all.
You know, the foul drowner's coming in with the storm. The eternal flame showing up here to deal with this magic.
Someone near our fire creeps.
I'm sure we'll have some sort of a malevolent spirit to banish as well. Here we go.
The sacred ground is with blood stained. We cannot the ritual complete. People, save yourselves. If your lives you value, run.
God damn, Peller. Real shitstorm you've kicked up here, sir. A real shitstorm indeed. All right, let's see here. Let's see. We'll get a little Spectre oil on here. Very good. I wonder how my toxicity is faring at this point. I'm dying. There we go. Oh no, watch out for the triple blast, my friend. Watch out for it. Better get a little water into you there, Vitcher. Oh. Since you want a fiery ride back to hell.
Alas, all is lost.
Gotta be a peasant who told the witch hunters about the ritual. That spirit they drove away. Your father's ghost, right? Threatened to come back, likely to keep his word.
Old man Ambrose, the Peller fears not.
Wraith called you a patricide.
That Wraith called you a patricide. He get it right?
Aye,
If I'm gonna help you, I gotta know everything. Why'd you kill your father?
The Peller does not wish to speak of this.
Peller! Loosen your tongue! We have to do something. It must begin with the whole truth. And nothing but the truth, Peller. Yes.
You can't hope to manage this alone. You're afraid, that's clear. Wraith will hold sway over you. Listen, I'll send him off. I've got to. But I need to know where he's buried. Corpse probably hasn't turned to dust yet. That's his bond to the world of the living.
Ambrose lies in the swamp.
Fine. I'll find his body, see what I can do.
Awesome. Oh, and we hit level 11. And, Witcher, you're looking rough, sir. You're looking rough. And, in fact, that, despite the fact that it felt a little awkward at first, trying to work without having the swallows, you know, we all saw how that went down. And the way I died quite quickly. Ooh, a witch hunter's sword. It's nice, nice. Up. Despite the fact that it was a little shock to the system, I did realize quite quickly that with that one, with the decoction that I had chosen, which was the Night Wraith one, so Geralt's maximum vitality is increased with each foe killed, I'm pretty sure that, it was actually healing me. You know, each kill was not only increasing my maximum vitality, but giving me a little bit more health in the process. Because I came out of that first round against the Drowners with, you know, when the Witch Hunters arrived on the scene, I was at full health, you know. So I don't know if the game just automatically healed me or if it was something that was happening while I was slaying that foul hag and her, well, her legion of minions, yes. Anyway, not bad. I like the way it works, and you can see it's still in my inventory, so clearly this can be refilled, or I would imagine it can be, with some strong alcohol upon meditation, which is awesome. Alright, and I've got my water for healing right now. I might as well put the white honey aside. Actually, no, I'd better keep it there, you know. My toxicity, I could have sworn my toxicity should be dropping a little bit faster than that. I thought it simply worked itself away, but it may not actually deplete until the effect of the decoction wears off, you know. That's what I'm starting to wonder. Alright, how are we doing here? Let's collect what I can. And then we'll look into, well, what the pillar has now tasked us with. I'll tell you, there's a lot of bloody loot out here. I'm still pissed that I spoiled this fantastic mission. Oh, with just a bumbling death to open. But that's fine. The second run through there was pretty good. There was just something about this, and the game just continues to impress people. I mean, it really does. Oh, it was just great. You know? The setting, the whole vibe with the storm rolling in, and just random Drowners. I mean, the Drowners had nothing to do with the ritual at all, you know? Clearly, they're part of this whole mission, right? But they just rolled in with the storm, basically. You know? And, of course, somebody had told on us. Oh, someone in the mob. Ratting us out to those foul witch hunters. Who were here to take the Peller's head, clearly. His head and his hide, yes. Anyway. Oh, what is this? Look at this. Oh my. We got a loot chest over here. Meteorite ingot. Well, nothing too spectacular. But it's better than nothing. It's better than a kick in the nuts. Yes, yes it is. Yes it is. We'll say that much. Alright, let's roll on out of here. I'm glad, you know, because I'm glad that there was something that drew us to this little area, you know, because it definitely, it stood out to me when I first moved across to Fake Isle, right? Alright, let's go into the journal and really have a good look at things here now. Secondary quests, Forefather's Eve. So at this point I need to find the body of the Peller's father in the swamps using my Witcher senses. Now, is he gonna be out here on Fake Isle? I highly doubt it. He'll be elsewhere, would be my guess. So we'll get to that next episode, I would imagine. And I do have to return to Keira, Metz, a favor for a friend. I guess I've got a little bit of time. I could try and make the journey here. What I would like to do quickly is take a look at the map and see where I'm heading for the Peller. Oh, good. That's, you know what? That is bloody perfect. You know, I'm heading there anyway. Just one more reason to be there, and I can take care of all my business from Reardon Manor to Leslov to Downwarren with the Baron and Gran to the Peller's father's remains here lost in the swamp for many years. I'll be able to do all of that in one sweep, in one journey over there. Perfect. For the time being, let's go back to the journal and let's get Keira up here. And maybe wrap this episode with a, well, with a happy ending. Yes, yes, yes. Mine's out the gutter, please, my friends. Please, stop it. Anyway, let's hop on a boat here. And we'll sail for Kira's house. Oh, don't drown here, Vetcher. You know, and he's all jacked up with the toxicity, oh my. He needs some tender love and care. Hopefully Keira will see that, and then finally, yes, she'll slip on this lingerie. We're bringing her, yes. And it will be a night of sweet, sweet love with the woman. Yes, with the sorceress. Now, I also am thinking maybe I should head Orton's way. But I'm not going to go there looking for a game of cards in the middle of the bloody night. No. No, I refuse to do it. Now, Roche, where are you? Trekking through the muck here.
Let's go.
Very good, Witcher. Making a grand announcement that we are to set off. I got something. Oh, we got a foglet over here. Could be fun. Could be fun. Level 10 foglet as well. Oh wow, there's two of them there. Oh, he's got his little mind minions. Yeah, yes. Oh, and of course, they're pestering Roche. The foglets, they love the horse meat, yes. What's happening here? Taking some serious lumps. Get a little water in. Oh, just the time of day, you know. And two of them in here with their minions. The fog growing thick on all sides. Oh wow, getting a good walloping from this pair. Dang it! Did I do damage to myself there? Damn it, Vetcher! What are you doing? Nice! One falls just like that. Where is he? I can feel him, he's close. And yes, wonderful. The art sign comes in. In fact, my rage management was what allowed me to get that art sign in as quickly as I did. And the Vitcher wasted little time driving both of them through when they finally did hit the ground. Alright, a creepy little fight here in the woods on this eve. Have myself a little bread. We'll mount up. I'm running a... Well, I wouldn't say we're running long just yet. We're probably sitting around 45. Where exactly am I in relation to Kira's place? I've got a bit of a jaunt ahead of me here. We're just passing by the remains, the ruins of Wastrel Manor. Could be worth inspecting here. I don't know. We do have a mission in there. I think for the time being, what I'll do is I'll ride for Kira's place. It's good to know that there's a mission in here. I think I'll probably return You know, I gotta pass back through the area to get... If I want to stop in Oriton, if I want to head for the bog. I'll just make sure that, Wallstrom Manor is on the sightseeing list, yes. Alright, now if I'm not mistaken, we're moving into Necker country. Actually, right down here is where the foul drowners are. I can smell the Necker piss a mile away, yes. Yes, I can. Foul stuff, that Necker piss. Oh my god, people. You wouldn't believe it if I told you. Alright, I don't know what I'm doing here. Lost in the darkness. Lost and sick. Toxicity all jacked up. Yeah, my toxicity hasn't moved. I wish that there was something to maybe lessen my toxicity without completely diminishing or destroying my active effects, you know. There could very well be a potion of some kind that I can brew in time. I don't know. Anyway, Akira, I've come a-knockin', my dear, on this fine eve. I have a little box for you. It clearly has your sexy lingerie in it, yes. I demand you put it on, this instant. Anyway.
Geralt, just when I was starting to miss you.
Really? You can see she can't go too long without me anymore, no. We've clearly bored our way into her mind, yes. Anyway, I've got what you requested of me, my dear.
Got those, substances you wanted.
Splendid. I can finally begin my study of double arboreal racination patterns. But first, I'll...
Brew yourself a mug of mulled wine. Saw what the wagon was carrying. Exquisite meats, expensive wines, Zeracanian spices. Not a speck of magic. Care to tell me what you're up to?
I would rather show you. But you must wait a bit.
Oh, very, very good. Very good, my dear. I like it. There it is. There it is. The makings of one romantic night. Yes. With Keira Metz. Fine. I will wait, my dear.
Color me intrigued. Fine. I'll wait.
Then shoo outside.
Gonna slip into something more comfortable.
I knew it was...
Let's not get ahead of ourselves.
I knew it was a box of lingerie.
Well, go on. Out.
Fantastic. Alright, I'll be waiting for the call. I've got my magic lamp ready.
You've been patient, thank
you. Oh, here we go, sometime
it's almost
later.
Almost ready.
Excellent. What is this now?
Huh? If I wanted to see white mice, I'd just get drunk.
Note that I said almost. Now don't interrupt.
What's the fairy tale with the pumpkin? I don't know, Cinderella or something like that. Anyway, what happened to the third mouse, my dear?
Third mouse, what happened to it?
The spell has a 66.67% chance of success. I always use one more than I need, just in case.
So where did... Keira, can I explain what's going on here?
Know the fairy tale about Cinderella?
Mm-hmm. True story it's based on, too. A Zugul cropped up in a palace pond and ate Princess Cinderella whole, left behind one slipper, so...
I beg you, not another word about Zugals. Now, to return to the fairy tale. I'd like to escape these ghastly swamps for one magical night.
Excellent.
I don't need a fairy godmother. I'll cast the spells myself. But I could use a Prince Charming.
Yes, a rugged veteran, in fact.
It just so happens you're the only decent candidate in all Venom.
With a lice-ridden beard.
What do you say to a moonlight ride on horseback? And dinner?
And? With pleasure on the side? Yes, yes. Of course, my dear.
Sounds tempting.
Would be a good,
so
good time
tempting,
for a cliffhanger.
I don't think I can refuse.
Before we go, there's one more thing.
Gotta transform a pumpkin into a carriage?
No.
It's awesome.
I shall transform our rancid rags into something more glamorous. Don't wince. It'll
speak for yourself, my dear.
A bit.
I've got some fantastic gear on
everything
here.
Everything will return to normal.
Good, good. Very well. Have fun. Why not? Just do whatever makes you happy, my dear.
Why not? Might as well go all out.
Then hold on tight. Gvela Glan. So, what do you think? Neckline too modest?
It's just right.
Well, I might also have changed your hair color while I was at it. I've always fancied dark men.
What? I wasn't even looking.
Oh well, any port in a storm.
Well, off we go. Dinner's waiting.
Good.
Last one there does the dishes.
I don't know if I approve of this poofy shirt. This poofy shirt, my dear. Alright, well, I think I'm gonna have to wrap it here, my friends. We're running 50 minutes here. In fact, I may just cut out this night. It may not be for your... Well, your innocent eyes, no.
Master.
I will, we'll pick this up next episode. Appreciate y'all stopping on in. I hope you had a good time. I hope to see you next time. You've got incentive to return, I promise you. Till then, remember why it hurts. Later, all.